In Argentina, the Grandmothers of Plaza de Mayo have been nominated once again for the Nobel Peace Prize. If you still don't know about them, this is your chance to do so.
Life overcame hatred. That's what Estela de Carlotto, president of the Grandmothers of Plaza de Mayo, says despite the difficulties she faced. They couldn't defeat her in her fight of justice that has now lasted for over 40 years.
This recognition honors us, of course. In any case, we are happy to be in our country with all those who love and care for us, because the struggle continues and we do not feel alone. We are well accompanied. There is more and more solidarity, support and sympathy for the work we do.
The search for those disappeared during the military civic dictatorship is now recognized worldwide. Today, a new chapter emerges in this long path of recovery for the 127 missing children, a new nomination for the Nobel Peace Prize.
We know the grandmothers for what they do in Argentina, but the presence and importance that the grandmothers have globally is enormous. Everything that has to do with the right to identity and international declarations of human rights, we owe it to the grandmothers. That's the main reason we have nominated them for the Nobel Peace Prize.
True triumph over lies, and the grandmothers celebrate this nomination by working. Now, they are accompanied by the love of their recovered grandchildren.
In spite of the grief and horror that they went through, all they asked for was justice. I think they are an example that has transcended borders.
I think there is no better prize than to give the Nobel Peace Prize to an organization that fights for life as a symbol of truth in moments where there is denial, where the policies of human rights are falling. I think it will be of great honor for them to be recognized.
The grandmothers of Plaza de Mayo celebrate life once again, but they also know there is still a lot to do in their quest for truth, memory, and justice.